Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you to this panel here. I hope that we will have a vivid discussion among us, also including a lot of questions from the audience here. I'd like to start this this panel here with a little of an anecdote. I took my little son with me this morning to Berlin, and on the way he asked, "Hey, Dad, what are you doing here?" So I said, "Well, I'm on a panel and I give a talk," and he asked, "What is it about?" "Okay," I said, "it is about the question, is the West and so on enough doing?" Well, he said, "What do you mean with West? US, Canada?" And I said, "Well, that's actually the right question, because if we review all the talks today, even the last one, I think it's always a question of where do we put our origin into it." Okay, so I'm from education and part electrical engineer. And as electrical engineers, we like to talk about grounding things. It doesn't mean anything else than we say, that's zero at this point. But what is zero? So the same question we can ask here. So where is West? Is West now west of Africa? Or is this west of the Atlantic? Where does start West? So I think with all those questions, this question which is written down, we do have to define first what is West, what is enough? When is it enough to teach? That's a question. Then, what is the right kind of education? I think, you know, I just come back from Cameroon. I saw people fixing tires on the street. You know, ask anyone in Germany to do this one. They say, well, you have to go to a tire shop and they have an electronic balancing system and all that one. Is this really necessary? Is this the right one? The right education? And so what is education at all? What do we mean with it? And I think those are, I think there are enough keywords in that question to rise and discuss here. So I like to basically go around and have a first collection of ideas. What do you think, based on your background, which topic or which keyword do you like to define here and give your impression on it? So I would like to start with ladies first here. So we go to the right. So which keyword would you like to pick of the question? Is the West doing enough to promote the right kind of education in Africa?
Yeah, that's very difficult, but maybe perhaps education.
Okay.
Yeah, and as you have pointed it out, in terms of education, what is the definition of education? Is it our understanding of education in African context, or is it understanding of education in the European context? Because I would believe that there are various ways of educating people in a society. And one of the things I think in Africa, or in, I'll speak of Malawi because I haven't lived in throughout the, we think of Africa as a country, but really it's a continent with many various kinds of countries. I'll speak of my country, Malawi. We have various kinds, forms of education that we learn. We learn through learning from society. We can learn through passing on from the elders to the young ones. We can also learn through the formal education. I mean, as they're calling formal education, is it like an institution where you go to primary school or secondary school or tertiary education? So for me, I think also one of the biggest role, whether one of the things that we should look at into is what's there and how can we improve such, because there are various ways of educating a society, educating a person, educating a child. And some of those methodology, maybe we should look into that, and perhaps there are some cultural, like traditional way of doing educating someone, and that can we can tap, because we always think that maybe going through the other ways is the best way, but there are also other forms of education that we should look into. For now, that's what I can just say. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. So we have the topic education right now. Has anyone an idea when education started in mankind? What required education? When did the first time education happened? Well, I read an article sometime a few months ago. Their answer was, when we got old enough that two generations were living together, when the elderly people could teach the younger kids their experiences so that they haven't had to do that experience over and over again. So the question is, first we have to get old enough, or we have to have someone to tell something. So I think that's a good point that you pointed this one perfectly out. I think that was great. So, what is your opinion? Which keyword is most important, or which one would you like to define here?
Yeah, I understand education a little bit as I see just defined. And at this level, I mean, education from west to the south, for me would be something which is more or less well done. I mean, yeah. When we look at around, I would take the case of Cameroon, for instance. You see that the know-how, the Western know-how, is not what we are missing. I mean, most countries in Africa. So in that respect, there is a fair transfer of knowledge, that the education from the west to the east, in that respect, is not is something which is well established. It's well established. The question is now: is does African continent profit from this education that their people are receiving? So at that level, I would say not entirely, because the output is there. We know how the country is not yet completely emerging, and they are still suffering. There's still a lot of problems. So, yeah, that's the way I can put this question, actually.
Thank you very much. I assume Mr. Ramsay will define West a little bit different, maybe west of Australia or so, in regard to the music. So what would you think about, what keyword would you like to pick up and give your contribution now after your talk?
Well, I think for me, the question of whether the West is doing enough or not enough is not the essential issue here. The main thing is Africa doing something about itself? And I have a feeling that many of the times that we are too focused on the West as a continent. I know that, for instance, in the music industry, if people thought about creating an internal market for African music, it might be a lot easier for them to sell their music abroad. So if you're producing and manufacturing products, I suppose it would be the same. If there's a market for your product in wherever you live, there's much more chance of you educating somebody to get a job in an industry, and then we don't have to start with manufacturing motor cars, probably, or atomic power stations, but probably we have to look at what the needs of the continent are, and then try to enter into a constructive dialogue with people who might be able to help make that process work. I think that seems to me, and it seems to me that what they call Berufsbildung in Germany is something quite important at the moment in Africa, apart from all the other things that there's, you know, and people who know how to run a transport industry so that you can get somewhere cheap and work, you know. And I think if we can invest in education, what kind of education do people need in order to set up a well-run bus service or a well-run train service, or and the advantages of living in a city like Dar es Salaam and being able to get somewhere fast without paying a fortune, more than you would pay in Europe to travel the same distance, much more, actually. I mean, this is the biggest impediment, I think, to development in many African countries, is the transport infrastructure is appalling in most countries. And I think maybe, I don't know, set a list of priorities. What's important? And then try to look at those. I mean, but just to say the West is not doing enough, maybe Africa has to actually define some priorities itself, you know, and then take those priorities seriously, you know, instead of waiting for somebody else to do something about it.
Thank you. So we moving now to the left, since I gave a little bit of an idea about a keyword West. So we move now to you. You're from South Africa, so you can give us an inside view from the bottom up to the tip of Africa. So what is your feeling about this question?
Okay, thank you, Prof. Looking into the concept of West Africa, I want to believe that there's a problem in looking into this. The concept of East-West came in during the Cold War international system, of which Germany, where we are today, is a very good example. We are talking about West Germany. We are talking about East Germany. The implication of it is that the communist, the capitalist. Now, the concept is being used globally now to mean the progressive state, the capitalist state, the pro-American state, and to some degree, the European Union. Now, when we are talking about whether the West is doing enough to develop education in Africa, I don't think we actually need any development from anywhere in order to develop our education. If my knowledge and what I read concerning the development of science and technology is correct, I want to believe that development starts from Egypt, which is part of Africa. And now talking about calling the West to develop our education. During the time of colonialism, our educational system was bastardized because all our norms, values, beliefs were relegated to the background. So many people believe that African religion is not the best. So it's either you become a Muslim or you become a Christian. And if you become a Christian, better for you. Sometimes when people are asking me what's the meaning of Samuel, I tell them, okay, Samuel, according to the Bible, I understand that there was a woman who was looking for a child. And the child was named Samuel from Professor Eli or something. After that, I don't have any interpretation to that. But when we are talking about Amusan and Olalere, I know the meaning. I know how these names comes from. Now, when we are talking about education in Africa, where we are actually getting everything wrong is the taking the value from the Western world into our educational system. And when we continue doing that, there's what we call environmental peculiarity. What applies in Europe may not be applicable in Africa. And that is one of the reasons why the concept of transfer of technology continue to make Africa to remain underdeveloped. So asking for technology, asking for curriculum from the West in order to develop our educational system, I don't think is a right option to get to the so-called promised land. Now, my solution to this problem. We need to differentiate between what we call quality education and quantity education. During the time of Plato, Aristotle, the means of their education is not the way, is not the one we are having today. As a teacher, you may have only one or two students, and you are the only one who is teaching that student. At the end of the day, that person is going to be productive. But today, because of amalgamation of so many ideas, either it is functional or it's not functional, bringing it to the African soil for us to take and believe that that is sacrosanct. That is the only thing that can make us develop. That is one of the areas that we are getting it wrong. Now on the issue, can I continue? Okay. I believe that what we need to do in Africa as a whole is to declare educational emergency. To have a conference, to discuss about our problems. Where are we getting it wrong? And where do we think we are getting it right? I remember a book written by one professor, late Professor Claude Ake, Social Science as Imperialism. When you look into the basic theories in social sciences, you realize that all these theories were developed based on environmental issues. I want us to look into the concept of feudalism, capitalism. Why did they develop this concept? Is it not for the development of the European state? So at the end of the day, where are we today? Nothing, virtually nothing is working. You may have 10 PhD, and when it comes to solving the solution of your immediate family, you may find it very difficult to solve. Then where are we going? Our elderly people, are we listening to them? Despite the fact that they have vast knowledge concerning our environment, concerning our beliefs, concerning our norms, concerning our values, do they listen to them? I mean, do we listen to them? Because we say that their own ideas is not Western, it's archaic. And for us that we believe that we marry a Western idea, where are we today? Thank you for now.
Okay, thank you very much for your contribution. So, we move on.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much, Professor. Maybe I should read again the question, is the West doing enough to promote the right type of education? I'm trying to answer your question. I think the professor here have re-explained what is West and what is real, maybe East, we can say. East is Africa, is among East, the poor countries, the West Arabic countries. As it is, you can draw the line between East and West in the map, world map, and that is East. And does the West doing enough to promote the right type of education? I can say yes, they are doing enough. There are a lot of funds in the world today, a lot of funds, uncountable funds, which are promoting education in Africa. And they give a lot of grants to students for higher education to study, and it's just all for free. And for me, what I see in Africa, the problem is there is, for example, in my country, Tanzania, about 80 to 90% of the people are educated, they have degrees. But if you go further, there's very high unemployment within the country. So the question is, why are there's very high unemployment? And when you look at the jobs, there are very high jobs availability. For example, I can give you the question of South Africa now. There are about 600,000 people who are unemployed, but 700,000 jobs which are available. So the problem of education also maybe it is within the societies of Africa also. We don't know what to study. We don't know what our countries really need. It's our own problem. The West cannot help us, but we have to know what to study, what to learn, how to learn, how to change our curriculums, not just to go to school and expect a job. We need a constructions within Africa. We need roads. We need things like this engineering. We don't have this type of education. And as a result, the Western people are studying in Europe. They come to take our jobs in Africa. So for my opinion, I think the Western have done enough. The problem now is within Africa itself. We have to sit down again and maybe to review our curriculums and provide the education which will run the countries. Because I don't, of course, Africa is one of the continents which education is very low in the world, but still the education is very high and we have a lot of people who are unemployed in the streets. So now we need to know what really to do to make the countries run. Because the countries, of course, we are educated, but our country still remains poor, as the professor have said. People have 6-7 PhDs, but still they are not solving the problems of the countries. So we need to know what to study, how to study. Education is there. How to study, how to utilize the education. Education does not remain in the heads. You have to use it to produce something. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So we have our last contribution here. May I ask you a specific question? We talk about Africa as it would be, you know, it's one unit. Yes. And throughout the day, we heard several times different. It started with Sudan. It's south and north. Mm-hmm. So from your perspective, can we talk about Africa just as a whole unit, as a target to deliver education?
Thank you. luckily enough, I worked in German universities, in British universities, and in North American universities. Therefore, I can say that I know the three systems at least. Every country has its own education system, number one. Number two, every country would like to promote its education system as the best. Number three, then they try to disseminate it or to transfer it to African countries. Ours is best. The Germans say ours is best. The Americans say ours is also best. And the British, etc., etc. It is up to the African countries. Always, we shouldn't forget we learn and benefit from others. But we need also to adjust it to our specific situation and on the ground. Therefore, what I can say is get benefit from those did it best, but take the best one that you can benefit from and adjust it to your local situation. If we do this one, then we will have a good system that will be productive, contribute to the economy and the human knowledge and so on. This is what I can say. Number two, education, of course, many countries from the east, the west, and the south and the north, they have different systems. For example, in the east, Tanzania, Uganda, Kenya, Ethiopia, for example, they have different systems with the historical background. Therefore, we cannot say. But what we can do is there are best system usually helped many countries like Germany to develop highly. We can take the good ones from them and adjust them. Why? Because we need to establish education as proactive and reactive to the society. Proactive and reactive also to the needs of society. That's what we need to establish an educational infrastructure or system in Africa, in all African countries. Another one here, Professor, my colleague, said that about the research. Let me say, I don't want to spend a lot of time. Knowledge creation and knowledge dissemination and application. We can create knowledge, in Africa, knowledge is created in different parts of the world, both developed and developing countries. But the application and dissemination is a problem. Therefore, we need to adjust African education system as innovate, to produce the young, the innovative young, and the productive young, the problem solver, not simply learning what others gave us. It serves them, it is also good, we can take it. Why? Because education is a joint collaboration. It's a joint enterprise. Let us learn from others. Let's think and adjust it to our local situation.
Thank you very much. So we heard different views now on that question, and I like your summary, basically, which is stating that we have to evaluate. So the question is, who should evaluate the educational systems? I think you can only do this one if you are very familiar with it. We both had been lucky to teach in different educational systems. When I was in the United States, I said, well, the spoon feeding here, that can't be right, education. I came back to Germany. I said, well, this scholastic teaching in the universities, which came up with the bachelor and master after Bologna, this can't be right. So I totally agree with you on that one, that there has to be an evaluation. And I think, what about if we rephrase this question? What would be your feeling if we would ask, how should we provide information so that education can be judged and implemented at the right levels in Africa? Because I think it was implied here, if I hear around, we have a high profile. If you want to see this one, we're leading institutions for teaching. We are ourselves professors, but shouldn't we look also at the other end of the education? If we look at the problems we heard today, there are a few people who are causing a lot of trouble and making the news. Shouldn't my question for you, and maybe also for the audience, that we expand this one, like we heard this one with this one lady, which was all over the world in the news, right? And that was an outcry. But what about educating first, or with a different emphasis, people on the street, so that they keep their values and that they can judge statements by other people? What do you think about that level of education? Because when we talk about Western support of education, we're talking about, going in institutes, supporting them, and so on. So what is your feeling about that question? At which level should education kick in with which emphasis?
Thank you very much. Before I answer your question, I think I would like to comment on the explanation given by Ms. Rahma Malick. I like you very much, but I think that there's a problem with what you said at the beginning of your conversation. I'm sorry to say, but I think everybody's free to give their own opinion here. You said is the West, and the question is the West doing enough to promote the right kind of education in Africa? And you said yes. Yeah. I understand your part, but for me, unfortunately, I will say no. And I think the question you ask is, which part of Africa? The West, the East, the North, or the South? And when you're talking about what the West is doing, as in giving sponsorship to who? Is it in the eastern part of Africa, maybe Kenya? Because when we're talking about Africa as a whole, maybe we should talk about the problem of unity. Because Africa as a whole is not united. Everybody wants to say, I'm African, I'm from West Africa, I'm from Eastern Africa. And so when it comes to people being sponsored from the West, unfortunately, maybe only 1% or 2% from Nigeria. So that's West Africa. So I'm sure maybe when you're trying to kind of generalize Africa, maybe you should kind of be very careful in stating which part of Africa. And that on the issue of the education and the right kind of education on the street, Professor Amusan said maybe Africa should be able to handle their own education themselves. And I think he's right, because I remember when I was in I studied both in private and public secondary school. And I remember that we were taught more of African literature. We read more of Africa, not just Nigeria, but we went as far as going out of reading African literature, even as far as Kenya. And I think the intention was to promote African culture so that we will know that we are Africans, not just only in Nigeria. And I've been able to teach other people about the education on the street, and it has to do with the African themselves and the right kind of education that has to come from the culture first, not just from the outsider. It has to be from the internal education first before being allowed from the external source. Otherwise, because right now, Professor said we have lots of PhD. I think it does. I mean, like I said yesterday, that was all about the title. But I can tell you that even most of them cannot even have a solution to their problem in many ways. What is different? What's this having a qualification and you cannot justify it in a way practically? It doesn't make sense. So if we are talking about the right kind of education, we are talking about in Africa, then we have to look at the internal source, the internal way of learning, of teaching people. Is it about the culture we are going to teach them? Because we have lots of hopes. There are many hope in Nigeria. And that means what we can learn can come from the Africa itself, not from the outside. I mean, I think that's the only solution, because when we're talking about here, we have never seen a place where Africa will come and learn from the Westerner. But the Westerner has always been the one bringing their own ideas to us. And I think this is the right time has come for us to stop this, because if it continues like this, I'm telling you, the next generation of Africans, we always have to learn from the Westerners, but we cannot give them their own ideas and our cultures. So I think that's my own point of view on this. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for your comment. You want to comment on this? Yeah, okay, please, because you have been addressed.
Yes. Thank you very much for your comment on this. But I said Western have done already enough for Africa, because I believe we Africans ourselves, we are the ones who are responsible to make better our own education. Western countries cannot take every person from the street and help. But we ourselves, I believe whatever they have done is enough, because we have also to remember these are the countries which they have their own people in their own nations. For example, in Germany itself, they have 500,000 uneducated people. So it means the government of Germany itself have a duty to do here in Germany by itself. So I believe European countries have done enough, and we should really say thank you for that. And we also, Africans, we have to stand up and do something. This is what I mean. And I agree, Africa is big, of course, and we have a lot of regional segregation within. For example, we have East African community, we have SADC, and we cannot really say Africa as Africa. Africa is really by itself divided so much. Thank you.
Okay, we have one lady who is waiting desperately.
Going to explode. I just have a comment. Okay, my name is Bashara, I'm from Sudan, a very powerful Sudanese woman. I just want to comment on that. For us, most of the Africans, the educated person is the person with a degree. And I think we should change this. We should change this stereotype of a person who's educated being someone who's academic. I want to point out the case of Philippines. Philippines is a country with very poor resources, but with very rich human resources. In Sudan and in other countries, most of the nurses are from Philippines. Most of the welders are from Philippines. Why don't we work on encouraging people to get vocational training, to get vocational education, to have our own skilled labor instead, you know, because all of the Africans, me included, I am working at a university. I consider myself educated because I have a master's degree, but this is not true. Even those laborers, skilled labor, are people who are educated. So one of the professors yesterday said that in Africa we have the land and we have the people. They don't have to be educated, just professors, but we can have vocational skilled labor who are able to be employed in their own land, in their own country, and to promote their own countries. Thank you.
Thank you very much. This was a nice final talk. We have one last comment, a short one, very short one. Okay.
I should be very frank here. We Africans always try to blame others. The Western countries have their own system. It served them, full stop. It is up to us to learn, take the good one, assimilate it or associate it with our own. Then we can disseminate it to our people. That is what we should do. We need to have the right people, the right place, the right position, so that they will lead us, and then we can improve the education system. Blaming doesn't produce anything. Why? Because every country works for its own advantage. There is a competitive advantage. We need to see the rationality of competitive advantage. Nobody will think better than us. We need to think for ourselves. We need to take the good one, assimilate it. It is a joint collaboration. Therefore, we need to believe in that. Blaming will not be productive and will produce very little for us.
I have a comment. You know, I have a problem with the, hey, turn it down a little bit. I have a basic problem with the premise. It reminds me, Dr. Amusan, he said something to remind me of a movie. It's called Black History, Lost, Stolen, or Strayed. If you look at the history, because if you go back, let's say when I was a schoolboy in the 50s, and you look at what was being taught about Africa, Africans were literally written out of history. I'm the product of African ancestors on one side of my family. Africans, Asians, I don't care, all points on the compass have made contributions to what we are calling knowledge. And education is only the acquisition of that knowledge. So what is the premise for the arguments? I think a couple of things have to be made clear to the people that we're going to educate, no matter where they are on this planet, is that we all have made a contribution in over thousands of years. I mean, I was pretty good in mathematics and I had Euclidean geometry, but Euclid lived perhaps 4,000 years after the pyramids were built. If you don't understand geometry, you're not building any pyramid. If you don't have a fundamental understanding of science, you're not going to build these buildings. They're still trying to find out logistically how these buildings were even built. So we have monuments, you know, etched in time that demonstrate the contribution that all humans have made to knowledge. Another thing is that knowledge is universal. It doesn't belong to a continent, a city, a state, a piece of earth. It's all out here. It's the known and the unknown. So I think that it's important. It's very important. You talk about blame. I think we do have to point at the finger at people who have written people out of history, out of the collective history of humanity. And the question begs to be asked, why would they even do that? Well, they do that because, I'll answer that question, they want to better their position. They want to place themselves on top. So that has to be pointed out. We cannot gloss over that fact. That cannot be done. And if we look at Western education, and certainly I was educated in the West, I'm from Detroit, I'm from the United States, But there is an Atlantic Ocean between Western Europe and the United States. So this whole thing about West and East, when they talk about the Western world, they're talking about Western Europe, the Atlantic Ocean, and the United States, which is a ridiculous proposition to begin with, all right? So my point, just to be very brief, is that
I take you by your word.
By my standard, I'm being brief. Okay, sorry, but 30 seconds. We must historically look at this. I'm not, you know, you were saying, yeah, Africans have to help themselves. Of course. Well, they have to help themselves. However, we are human beings sharing the same planet, the same home. We have to help each other. And those who have benefited from the exploitation of all of these colonies, they are duty-bound to help the people who have suffered. That's it.
Thank you very much. I got a 5-minute sign, I think, 15 minutes ago. So I think we should wrap it up at this point. I'd like to conclude this one in the following way. On one hand, well, we shouldn't talk about Africa. On one hand, like this sir said, it's a global thing we can rely on. We should look and evaluate. This was one thing which had been pointed out to us here, that we should look at, pick the good things, learn from the time other countries spent. You know, they went through an evolution in society, in knowledge. So we don't have to make mistakes again. Sometimes you do have to do those ones. This is like a normal life. On the other end, it is, in my opinion, that way. Sometimes we have to get old enough to really turn away from blaming, for example, our parents, to cherishing them, what we have learned from them. So I would say that's something we should take home at this point with the question, is the West doing enough? I think the West started doing something. It did something. I never saw so many GIZ cars all over the world than in Yaoundé, Cameroon last week. More GIZ cars than government vehicles. Literally, I was astonished. So there is something going on, but I know exactly that in other countries, they pull out. So it is a distribution. It's a question, where do they put something? And on the other hand, that was mentioned on the panel also, it is the responsibility of the one who wants to receive something, to make something out of it. As an engineer, that's a feedback loop. So if the feedback is positive, you will improve, you enhance your knowledge. If it is negative, you can be happy if it stays at the same level. So in this meaning, I would say we can wrap up this panel now at this time and say, I think there is a good starting point, and from both ends, we have to join the forces and add them up that they go in the right direction. Thank you very much for everyone's contribution, and I hope that you have a nice break.